India is the second largest market for Google, and we have here with us Sukhinder Singh Cassidy, President, Asia Pacific, Google. Welcome, Sukhinder, to the show. Now tell us, what does India mean for Google Inc.?
I think today Google India represents already a user base of 40 million on the PC, 200 million or so on the mobile phone. So it is a formidable user base by any standard when measured against any mature or developing economy. Even more importantly, I think Google products have historically done very well in India. So we have a number of key products in the Indian environment, Gmail, Orkut, YouTube, even mobile, our mobile products that do disproportionately well for Google globally.
When do we see Orkut.co.in happening?
I think it's definitely something that we are considering. I can't give you a definitive timeline for launch. The Orkut experience is already a highly Indian experience. I think you're looking for a local domain, and as I said, we don't have a specific timeline for that launch.
You know, MVNOs or mobile virtual network operators are soon going to be a reality in India. Considering that you have a focus on mobiles in India, would you be looking at the MVNO model?
You know, I think our bets in mobile more broadly are around two areas. First and foremost, compelling search applications on the phone. And as I said, whether that's a WAP-enabled phone, whether that's over SMS, or in fact even voice in India is applicable. So I think a continued investment on the application and content side is probably our first and foremost focus. Number two, I would say, versus thinking about sort of the MVNO environment, I think we're looking more broadly at the paradigm of how to get more interoperability of applications on different mobile phones and innovation.
Is Google looking at acquiring some small companies in India?
You know, I get asked this question often, and I can tell you this, our appetite for talent, technology and innovation continues. I'm probably very excited about the investment from the VC community in India, because I think we've seen over the past year and a half, of course, an acceleration in this area, and our hope is it spurs a great amount of Indian innovation targeted at the Indian user, right? Versus the maybe historical paradigm of great Indian entrepreneurs going to the US and Silicon Valley and innovating for Western users. So I'm really excited about this generation of investment focused on Indian innovation. We continue to look at companies in this area, some of them doing interesting things, some we'll partner with, some we'll learn from, and perhaps some will become part of our broader family.
Now let me take you to a very different level. Considering that there is a perceived threat of slowdown in the US economy as well as in the Indian economy, do you see the business suffering in India as well as in the US because of this?
You know, it is an interesting question. First, I would say that one of our senses about a slowdown, and this is something that Eric has talked to our US investor community about as well, is that in a slowdown, marketers are looking even more for ROI-based investment and results, right? And I think we feel very good about the model of advertising that we bring to the table because it is inherently measurable and it works. And I think marketers can quickly see the efficacy of that spend or lack thereof. If it's a platform that's not working for them, you know, that is sort of the ultimate measure of whether or not they should be spending money with Google or not. And I think we feel very good about an ROI-based advertising model in a world where perhaps people are starting to watch the bottom line or their OpEx costs.
Finally, one last question. What is the next frontier for internet technology? Where do you see it going from here?
We're betting that our products and systems should be open and allow for that interaction between the external community, whether it's developers or users, and Google. And I think that's one big bet. I think the other is the notion of cloud computing, which Eric has often referred to, our CEO, which is the notion that we believe the movement away from a client-based application infrastructure to one in which your data and applications rest on the cloud or on the internet is an important one. And I think it's even more important for internet economies that are emerging.